General and the entire UN system for organizing this event. And I would also like to extend my appreciation and thanks to Christiana, who keeps us going, although he knows very well that this whole thing came to us as a bit of a surprise, having sleepless nights and long days. That's something we did not sign up to. But having said that, we're here, we're in the middle of the second week, or the beginning of the second week, and we hope that we can get to a good outcome out of Doha. What has food security to do with climate? I think for a country like Qatar, everything. We are a net importer of food. 90% to 95% of our food comes from the outside world, from your countries. And if you're impacted, we will be impacted directly. So the causal link between climate change and food is very strong. And for a country that is completely dependent on imports of food, we're very alarmed by what will happen in the future and the present. And we've been able to refer to several major incidents that happened in the US. The frequency of such are always increasing. We have seen the tendency of export restrictions happening left, right, and center since 2008. Only recently we've seen also some countries follow that very model. It brings alarm and worry about many countries. There are 2 billion people that live in dry land, 60 countries. And they represent the majority of the hungry people around the world. So what is Qatar doing about it? Qatar is planning to solve this problem at a domestic level, but the multipliers of that are immense. If we start adapting technologies that are developed for northern hemispheres to our conditions, it means that we can we will allow many countries to have access to such technologies and solutions at an affordable pricing. If we start putting together political momentum and gathering around this issue by those countries that are most affected, then they will be taking serious measures to address this problem. If we start putting alliances and research and development and science, then we can achieve some concrete goals. And so Qatar has done 2 main programs since 2008. It launched its domestic program, which is Qatar National Food Security Program, mainly to produce water using renewable energy. 100% of our water is desalinated, and that consumes an enormous amount of solar, fossil fuel. We're going to switch that to solar. That, in turn, will go to our farmers. The second program that we're doing is the Global Dry Land Alliance. It's an alliance in formation. It hasn't even been established. It will take about another 12 months for it to be created. Last month, we've organized a conference along with a lot of the UN agencies and probably and some local and others international to basically bring focus on this issue. Thanks to the World Bank for helping on this program. We convened 11 ministers from dry lands, and the draft declaration was adopted, and the focus was we need to dedicate substantial amounts of our budgets, up to 10% to agriculture. We need to focus on knowledge sharing, and we need to start acting fast. The situation is deteriorating by the hour.